In this section, we'll discuss the effect of constant external force on a simple harmonic motion. To understand the concept, let us take an illustration. Say, we are given with a spring block system placed on a smooth horizontal surface. And say the block is of mass m and the spring is having a force constant k. Now, you know well that if the block is slightly displaced by a distance y and released, it will experience a restoring force on it, and the restoring force will be given as minus ky. And further, we can write the acceleration of block will be minus k by my, which can be equated to minus omega square y, and we get the value of omega. So, here the value of omega will be root of k by my, which we can find out the time period of oscillation. Now, let us consider the situation again. If in the same situation an external force is applied on the block, obviously, say if we apply an external force, say a constant external force, F0 is applied on the block, and obviously the spring will be elongated in a new equilibrium position in presence of the force F0. Say if this is the new equilibrium position, here we can state that the block will be displaced by a distance y0 due to the external force F0, and in this equilibrium position as external force F0 is present and the spring will be applying a force ky0. So, at new equilibrium position we can write F0 is equals to ky0. Now, if we displace the block by a further distance y from the equilibrium position, we can state in this situation, at this new position, the net restoring force will be in inward direction, and we can say at a further displacement y, a restoring force will be, this restoring force will be k y0 plus y minus F0, and we can put a negative sign as the net restoring forces toward the equilibrium position. So, at this position a spring will be stretched to a length y0 plus y. So, spring will be exerting a force k times y0 plus y, and F0 is opposite to that. So, net restoring force will be given by this, where ky0 and F0 will get cancelled out, and you can see the restoring force still will be minus ky, which is exactly the same which was in the case when no external force was there. This shows even if an external force is applied on a situation when the body is in stable equilibrium, then external force shifts the equilibrium position to a new position, but it will not affect the angular frequency of oscillation as restoring force still remains same with respect to mean position. Mathematically, in various manners, this can be accounted. So, let's discuss it further. So, as what we have studied, we can write due to an external force, external constant force, equilibrium position is shifted, but it will not affect the angular frequency of oscillation. And we can also analyze mathematically the situation. If a body is experiencing a force given as F is equals to minus ky plus some constant, say it is C1, and we can say the force is not directly proportional to displacement, but a constant factor is also there. It is representing a constant force, and it is representing a force which is directly proportional to the displacement y and opposite to y. So this net force acting on body will be you can say a superposition of two forces. One is a constant and other is proportional to the displacement. Now in this situation, if we find out the acceleration of body under the influence of this force can be written as F by M. This can be written as minus ky by M plus c1 by M. Now in this situation, the c1 by M is another constant which can be taken as c2. So acceleration can be written as minus k by my plus some constant c. So in this situation, we can state acceleration is not directly proportional to y, but it is a linear function of y along with a constant. So it can be rewritten in a different way, like from equilibrium position. If acceleration is given as a is equals to minus omega square y minus ym, where y is the net displacement of body and ym is the position of equilibrium of the body. So displacement of body from equilibrium position can be written as y minus ym. So this can be written as minus omega square y plus omega square ym, where ym is the position of equilibrium, or it is the position of mean position with respect to the considered origin, and omega is the angular frequency, which is a constant. So this relation can be equated as a equals to minus omega square y plus another constant. So whenever we can say in the expression of acceleration some constant term is there, it is only giving us an idea that mean position of particle is not at y equal to 0, it is at some position. So we can state in this situation, mean position is given as c by omega square. We can also analyze the equation of SHM for this situation. So as just now we have discussed, if acceleration of a body in motion is given as minus omega square y plus c, then this also shows that body is executing SHM. And in this situation, we can state it is executing SHM about mean position at ym is equals to c by omega square. If this is the mean position, we can write equation of SHM can be given as y is equals to ym plus a sine of omega t plus alpha. This will be the new equation of SHM, where ym is the shifted equilibrium position of body due to the presence of some external force. As we have discussed in the term of acceleration, whenever a constant term appears, it denotes that a constant force is also acting on the body. And due to the constant force, only the equilibrium position or mean position is shifted. Rest, the oscillating behavior of body remains same.